Hello, my name is David Grenache. I'm an associate professor of pathology at the University of Utah and a medical director at ARUP Laboratories. The development of the human lung is an exquisitely regulated and highly coordinated process of branching morphogenesis, angiogenesis, and alveolarization. A critical event in lung development is the synthesis of pulmonary surfactant that begins during the third trimester of pregnancy and prepares the lung to function as a gas exchange organ after delivery. Pulmonary surfactants function to decrease surface tension inside lung alveoli, which prevents the collapse of alveoli upon exhalation. Infants that are born prematurely are at risk of developing respiratory distress syndrome, or RDS, due to a deficiency of pulmonary surfactant. It is well known that the incidence of RDS decreases with increasing gestational age at delivery, such that the risk of RDS is very high in preterm infants and low in those born at term. Fortunately, there are effective treatments for RDS. The administration of corticosteroids to a woman with threatened preterm delivery can increase the production of fetal surfactant and thereby decrease the risk of RDS if the infant is delivered preterm. For infants who do develop RDS, the administration of exogenous surfactant is a very effective intervention. In 2010, RDS was the eighth leading cause of infant death in the United States, and so the prevention and treatment of RDS continues to be an issue of critical importance in newborn medicine. Clinical tests are available that assess the maturity of fetal lungs. These tests are performed on amniotic fluid and determine if a sufficient amount of pulmonary surfactant is present to prevent the development of RDS. Between 1971 and 1988, several fetal lung maturity tests, or FLM tests, were developed, but only three are presently in clinical use. These include the lecithin to sphingomyelin ratio, the detection of phosphatidylglycerol, and the lamellar body count. These FLM tests exhibit high sensitivity for immaturity and an excellent mature predictive value. However, because there are many false immature results, the specificity is poor, as is the predictive value of an immature result. So while a mature result is a very strong indicator of pulmonary maturity, an immature result is not a good predictor of RDS. Despite the excellent performance of fetal lung maturity tests, there has been a recent decline in their utilization. Published surveys have reported declining rates of FLM tests ordered by physicians, and when asked why, their belief that these tests are no longer needed for patient care is cited as the major reason for the decline. This decrease in FLM test utilization is reflected in their annual testing volumes that we have observed at ARUP. While FLM test orders remained rather steady between 2007 and 2011, a rapid decline was noted in 2012 that was sustained to the present day. Most importantly, there are several lines of evidence to support a decrease in fetal lung maturity test utilization. In its 2008 practice bulletin on fetal lung maturity testing, the American College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists recommended that FLM testing only be performed to demonstrate pulmonary maturity before a scheduled delivery at less than 39 weeks of gestation. However, the same group strongly discourages the practice of scheduled delivery before 39 weeks of gestation unless it is justified by medical or obstetric complications. In agreement with these guidelines, several studies have demonstrated that the delivery of infants before 39 weeks of gestation, even with a mature fetal lung maturity test result, is associated with an increased risk of neonatal respiratory complications, including RDS, transient tachypnea of the newborn, pneumonia, and respiratory failure. One multicenter study that examined neonatal outcomes of infants born between 36 and 38 weeks that had mature fetal lung maturity test results reported that the incidence of adverse outcomes in that population was 2.5 times greater compared to neonates born between 39 and 40 weeks. Another study also reported a significantly greater risk of adverse outcomes for neonates born between 37 and 38 weeks with mature fetal lung tests to those born after 39 weeks, prompting the authors to conclude that 1) documented fetal lung maturity testing is insufficient to determine an infant's readiness for postnatal life. 2, that fetal lung maturity testing is irrelevant when preterm delivery is medically necessary. And 3, that infants should not be delivered electively prior to 39 weeks of gestation, even if lung maturity is demonstrated. In light of this, it is time to consider if fetal lung maturity tests are medically necessary, given that there are effective therapies for infants at risk for or who develop RDS, that elective delivery before 39 weeks of gestation is strongly discouraged, and that the assessment of fetal lung maturity is irrelevant if preterm delivery is medically necessary. In summary, currently available fetal lung maturity tests have high sensitivity for identifying pulmonary immaturity and have high predictive values for lung maturity. Still, the frequency of fetal lung maturity testing is declining, likely because they do not improve fetal outcome, as is evidenced by studies that have shown that fetal lung maturity testing is not associated with a lower risk of adverse neonatal outcomes. Add to that the fact that advances in neonatal care, such as antenatal corticosteroid therapy and surfactant replacement therapy, have significantly decreased infant mortality rates due to RDS, it is logical to conclude that fetal lung maturity testing in modern obstetric medicine has come to the end of its era of usefulness.